Morning, everybody. Welcome to another Mark Board Party by Mike Bjork. Today is Tuesday, and it's May 19th. A couple items on the docket today, and we got the housing starts for the month of March. As you can see, we had a nice jump up in February, which came in at 1.194 million, and it was supposed to come down slightly to 1.17, and it dropped all the way down to 1.089. So a pretty big drop there in the month of March. We also got building permits, also a big drop here. We had 1.177 million back in February and dropped all down to 1.086 million. So housing is obviously very important to the economy, especially with their GDP primarily, because there's so many different industries that are kind of tied to it. And so this is something definitely we want to keep an eye on, as obviously we noticed last couple of months the home builders' confidence level, their index has been kind of been at 58 lately, and we want to see if that can jump up at all. As they're probably maintaining their status quo from where they are. Stock market's a little mixed today. Oil went up to about $41. Nasdaq, I think, is the only one that's down a little bit today. Of course, it's earnings reports. So yesterday was the first time that the market actually went the opposite direction of what oil did. Oil did drop to around 39, and I think it improved a little bit. But now that investors kind of seeing that oil stabilizing around the $40 mark, they're taking their money and putting in more risky assets as they feel that we're not going into a recession. They're more comfortable that we're not going into a recession. And again, oil has stabilized, so they're getting a little bit more comfortable and looking more at the earnings reports. So that's kind of what they're doing today. We had kind of a mixed bag out there with IBM struggling, but there's a few other ones out there that are kind of that are offsetting IBM. So again, Nasdaq's the only one that is down, whereas the Dow and S&P are both up today. We started the morning down lower. We started down about 12 basis points, which would trigger, but because by the time it comes to the West Coast, when the rates come out here, it basically improved, and now we're about only 3 basis points lower than when we left off yesterday. So basically that translates to pricing, a price change for the East Coast for the better, but for West Coast about the same as where we left off yesterday. So there's really not much difference from where we left off yesterday in terms for pricing on interest rates. All right, folks, you guys have a great day. I hope you guys enjoy yourselves. Again, this week is mostly earnings reports again, but we also have housing data out this week. All right, have a great day, and see you tomorrow. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.